Early on the afternoon of January 24th, 2014, I walked off a plane into San Francisco International Airport. 5 hours and too little sleep later, I walked into the Castro Theater for the first time, excited to watch Journey into Fear and The Third Man on the opening night of Noir City 12. The theme that year was It's a Bitter Little World, taken from this 1948 film. 26 of the 27 films screened were either American films set outside the United States or films produced in other countries, including 6 from France, 3 each from Argentina and England, 2 each from Japan and Mexico, and 1 each from Germany, Norway, and Spain. If Noir City 12 widened the geographic lens of titles that could be deemed film noir, then Noir City 15 widened the chronologic lens, with 4 films released after 2000. Despite a general understanding that titles authorities deem film noir are primarily black and white products of American studios in the 1940s and 1950s, these films actually span more than a century and come from dozens of nations. Realizing no universally accepted definition of film noir exists, I spent 2 years constructing a database of 4,820 titles at least one of 32 authorities deems film noir, including year of release and countries of production. To learn more, please watch episode 1, To List or Not to List. There is a link in the description below. Using these data, then, you and I will spend 3 videos tracking titles deemed film noir through time and place. While we cannot address every film from every nation released every year, we will absolutely hit the highlights. Database films were released between 1912, D.W. Griffith's 16-minute gangster film The Musketeers of Pig Alley, cited here only, and 2015, Sebastian Shipper's one-shot wonder Victoria, shown at Noir City 15. Database films were produced at least in part in 66 countries, assuming Germany, East Germany, and West Germany are distinct countries. While 87% of database films have one country of production only, they could have up to 7. Of these 66 countries, 58 were listed first for at least one database film. The United States leads with 2,762 database films produced at least in part here. Coming in second is the United Kingdom with 851, then France, 572, Italy, 290, Germany, all variations, 220, and Japan, 132. Of course, this simple count treats all database films the same, whether cited only once or all 32 times. My points metric, then, which incorporates appearances in sources with no more than 100 titles, paints a more accurate picture of the historical geography of film noir. Thus, 8 database films totaling 9 points were released in the 1910s, bookended by The Musketeers of Pig Alley and Broken Blossoms, both directed by Griffith and starring Lillian Gish. 7 were American, 1 was French. Then, in 1920, Robert Wienand directed the German Expressionist masterpiece The Cabinet of Dr. Caligari. With 5 points, it is the oldest film in the debatable category. Caligari is the first of 5 German database films, totaling 13 points, released between 1920 and 1924. The oldest database film produced in the United Kingdom was also released in 1924. Meanwhile, 5 database films were released in 1927. 1 was English, 1 was German, and 3 were American, including the first film to reach double digits in points, Josef von Sternberg's Underworld. A total of 24 database films released over the next 3 years, totaling just 48 points. The oldest database films produced in Japan were released in 1930, both directed by Yasujiro Ozu. Through 1930, then, 45 database films totaling 96 points were released. The 26 database films released just in 1931, however, nearly equal that total in points with 91. 16 are American, including 4 with 8 or more points. 2 are classic gangster films, with the original Scarface released the following year. The other 2 were written by a San Francisco-based author to whom we return shortly. Meanwhile, the top 2 films by points released in 1931 are possibly the first French poetic realist film, remade in 1945 as Scarlet Street, and a German masterpiece called M. M is the oldest database film in the universal category. While I refrain from speculating upon what was the first film noir in this video, M is a very strong contender. Indeed, 1931 feels a bit like film noir year one, except it proved to be a false start. Between 1932 and 1935, 96 database films were released in these same 5 countries, totaling just 200 points. During that time, though, Nazi Party leader Adolf Hitler became Chancellor of Germany. His rise to power spurred a mass emigration of talented artists and filmmakers, many of them at least partly Jewish. One was a 43-year-old visionary named Fritz Lang, who arrived in Hollywood in the summer of 1934. There, in 1936 and 1937, he directed 2 powerful films co-starring Sylvia Sidney that pointed toward a much darker tone to come. Between 1937 and 1939, meanwhile, French filmmakers produced a string of poetic realist films starring Jean Gabin, which Jean-Pierre Chartier labeled Noir, in October 1946. Chartier's comparison to later American films was not flattering. Less than 3 months after Le Jour se Levé was released, though, German tanks rolled west into Poland, signaling the start of World War II. A few months before the Blitzkrieg of Poland, a 40-year-old British director of international acclaim signed a 7-year contract with David O. Selznick. On March 21, 1940, Alfred Hitchcock's first American film opened in Miami. Rebecca is the oldest database film with at least 20 points, putting it in the top 5% by this metric at number 237 overall. A few months later, another film would find the son of Hungarian Jews being photographed by an Italian immigrant under the direction of a man born in what is now Latvia. Released on August 16, 1940, Stranger on the Third Floor is the oldest film in the top 100 by points. 2 other films released in 1940 top the 17 points of You Only Live Once, meanwhile, marking 1940 as another possible film noir year one. In January 1941, though, Warner Brothers released what appeared to be another of its high-quality gangster films. It was even written by the author of 1931's Little Caesar. 2 stars from the previous year's They Drive By Night carry this film. Except that High Sierra just misses the film noir top 50 by points. This is the opening salvo in what may be film noir's true year one. For this was the year Walter Huston's sons John decided that the third time was the charm. See, back in 1930, a former Pinkerton detective agent named Dashiell Hammett had published his third novel. The first film adaptation of The Maltese Falcon was released just 1 year later. Perfectly solid, it made little impact. Meanwhile, the less said about the bizarre 1936 adaptation Satan Met a Lady, the better. So when novice director John Huston released his version of The Maltese Falcon on October 3rd, 1941, once again starring Bogart, nobody knew what to expect. 5 years later, though, French critic Nino Franck would cite The Maltese Falcon as one of 4 films exemplifying an exciting new noir style of dark American crime film. In fact, Huston's adaptation of The Maltese Falcon is one of only 4 films deemed film noir by all 32 primary sources. Its 58 points is topped by only 2 other films I will discuss in later videos. Seven other films labeled University were released in 1941, including another top 100 film by points and some other film by a novice director. Points totals dropped over the next 2 years, however, despite the release of three more films in the top 100 by points, one directed by Hitchcock, and two presenting an exciting new on-screen pairing. One of these films was adapted from Hammett's fourth novel. This decline belies three significant developments, though. First, a different classic crime novel was being filmed for a second time. Written in 1934 by former investigative journalist James M. Cain, The Postman Always Rings Twice was first adapted by French director Pierre Chenal in 1939. 4 years later, Italian director Luchino Visconti filmed it as Ossessione. This is both the oldest and highest-ranking Italian database film, sparking the Italian neorealist movement. We return to Postman and Mr. Cain in the next video. 1 year earlier, meanwhile, Russian-born Val Lewton had become head of the horror unit at RKO Radio Pictures. His first production, directed by Paris-born friend Jacques Tourneur and photographed by Moussa Raka, was a low-budget masterpiece called Cat People. Eschewing elaborate and expensive costumes and makeup, Lewton and Moussa Raka instead infused the film with eerie darkness and creeping shadows. Lewton and Tourneur made two more films together in 1943, one based upon a novel by an emerging master of psychological suspense. That same year, Mark Robeson directed a Lewton-produced gem called The Seventh Victim, the highest rank by points of Lewton's nine RKO horror films in 5 years. The Leopard Man was adapted from a novel by Cornell George Hopley Woolrich, who also wrote as William Irish. In 1942, his novel The Black Curtain, the second in the so-called Black series, had been adapted by Jack Hively as Street of Chance. All told, 14 adaptations of Woolrich stories have more than 10 points, the most for any author. Between 1934 and 1940, three other brilliant directors also fled the Nazis, eventually landing in Hollywood, where they joined Lang, as well as the Canadian-born son of Ukrainian immigrants. These five men, thanks to five very talented writers, would each direct a film in 1944 that ranks in the top 30 by points. Indeed, 1944 is when film noir as we generally understand it truly took flight, thanks in large part to one of the greatest films ever made. But that is a story for next time.